Hello everyone, I am Sabarinath.
I am Prabhudev.
We are here to explain you something about Raman effect.
Raman spectrum, which was named after a great Indian scientist C.V. Raman. He was born in November 7, 1880. He was the first ever Asian scientist to receive a Nobel Prize in any branch of science. Now we will see what is Raman effect.
Raman effect, change in the wavelength of light that occurs when a light beam is reflected by molecules. When a beam of light transverses a dust-free, transparent sample of chemical compound, a small fraction of the light emerges in directions other than that of the incident beam. Now let us see its uses.
Raman spectroscopy is used in many variable fields. In fact, any application where non-destructive, microscopic, chemical analysis and imaging is required. Whether the goal is quantitative or non-quantitative data, Raman analysis can provide key information easily and quickly. Do you know why does the sky appears blue?
Scientists believe the sea was blue because it reflected the color of the sky. But Raman found that it was the water itself that caused blue light to scatter more than any other color. The discovery created a sensation around the world and was named the Raman effect. Want to know something about sunset and sunrise?
When the rays from the sun hit the atmosphere, they get refracted. Due to this, the sun appears to be at an apparent position, which suggests that it has already risen. The same happens when the sun sets. After setting, the sun still appears in the sky due to the same refraction phenomenon. Due to this, the sun appears to rise early by 2 minutes and set late by 2 minutes.
That's all we have about Raman spectrum.
Thank you.
A black hole is a region of space-time where gravity is so strong that nothing, no particles or even electromagnetic radiation such as light can escape from it. In the initial days of space research, it was believed that the black holes were space objects into which things could enter but never leave. However, this all changed in 1974 when Stephen Hawking proposed the groundbreaking theory regarding a special kind of radiation which later became known as Hawking radiation. Stephen Hawking came up with a theory proposing that black holes were not really black. In fact, he claimed that he could emit radiation. His theory stated that the mass of the black hole could have become energy, which could then be radiated away. He formulated this theory by combining insights of quantum mechanics, the science of how very smallest particles of the universe work, and Einstein's general theory of relativity. Due to the presence of Hawking radiation, a black hole continues to lose mass and continues shrinking until the point where it loses all its mass and evaporates. It is not clearly established that an evaporating black would also look like the Hawking radiation itself would contain highly energetic particles, antiparticles and gamma rays. Such radiation is invisible to the naked eye, so an evaporating black hole might not look exactly like anything at all. An evaporated black hole would be detectable from Earth only when it is evaporated within the solar system or close to the nearby star to us. Scientists and cosmologists don't completely understand how quantum mechanics explains gravity, but Hawking's radiation continues to inspire research and provides clue to the nature of gravity and how it relates to other forces of nature.
What is robotics? Robotics is an integrated study of mechanical engineering, computer engineering, electronic engineering. Robot is a device which is used to perform many tasks and it is programmable. These automated robots are very significant in this robotic era. These robots can take up the role of humans in many fields such as defusing the bombs, finding mines and shipwrecks. In 1954, George Devol digitally invented the robot which is programmable and it is called Unimate. George Devol is called father of robotics. There are many types of robots. They are scalar, delta, polar and mini. Advantages of robotics. Robots are more cheaper than humans. Robots are more stronger and faster than humans. Robots can do many works and it can work 24/7. Hence, absenteeism in the workplace can be reduced. Robots can work in extreme weather conditions, whether it is extreme cold or hot, space or underwater. It can work anywhere. Robots can replace humans in many fields. Robots can also be efficiently used in nuclear plants. Though there are many advantages, there are some disadvantages. Robots are emotionless and are concise. Hence, it creates an emotionless work area. Robots can never replace humans in any of the means. Robots, if malfunction, it takes many time to rectify it. Robots can perform only the programmed tasks, and hence it cannot handle the unexpected situations.